and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A very good morning to you and welcome to our service of worship on this feast of St. James the Apostle. And so as we gather together in worship today, we pray together the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires are open, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus our Lord. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. So let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh.
Let us pray. Merciful God, whose holy apostle St. James, leaving his father and all that he had, was obedient to the calling of your Son Jesus Christ, and followed him even to death, help us, forsaking the false attractions of the world, to be ready at all times to answer your call without delay, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The psalm set for today is Psalm 126, and the response is, "The Lord has done great things for us, and we rejoiced."
When the 10 heard it, they were angry with the two brothers. But Jesus called them to him and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. It will not be so with you. But whoever wishes to be great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be your slave. Just as the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, O Christ.
Please be seated. It will not be so among you. Whoever wishes to be great among you must be your servant. Many years ago, when I worked in London, I commuted most days on the tube. And it was during that time of commuting that London Underground introduced something called poetry on the Underground. Some of the advertising slots above the seats were given over to a poem. And so it was that I first encountered the Irish stroke Liverpudlian poet, Roger McGough, who in more recent years has hosted Radio 4's Poetry Please. And there was one poem that I read on advertising that has lived with me a long time. I can't quote it verbatim, because I've never been very good at that, but I know the rough gist of it. It goes something like this. I want to be the leader, I want to be the leader, I want to be the leader. Can I be the leader? Can I be the leader? Can I be the leader? I want to be the leader, I want to be the leader, I want to be the leader. Yippee, I'm the leader. Okay, what shall we do? I don't know why, but that poem has stuck with me for years and years and years. And probably over the years, I have reflected on it and thought more about what it actually means. Initially, I was perhaps quite sceptical about it. Someone who wanted all the position, but actually had got no idea what to do. In later years, I've come to have a slightly different view of that poem. I'm going to go from the world of Roger McGough and poetry to the Royal Military Academy. There is a book that is given to every officer cadet that passes through there, that has on the front the college motto, Serve. Let us pray. Look with mercy upon those whom he calls today, marks with a cross, and makes his disciples within the church. We pray for those who are soon to be baptized, for those who are preparing for confirmation, for those who are currently training to be authorized lay ministers within this deanery and diocese, for those who have your son formed around him a company who were no longer servants but friends, and he called all those who obeyed him his brother and sister and mother. Look with mercy upon our families and our friends, and upon the communities in which we share. Lord, in your mercy. Your son sent out disciples to preach and heal the sick. Look with mercy on all those who yearn to hear the good news of salvation and renew among your people the gifts of healing. Lord, in your mercy. Your son promised to those who followed him that they would sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel and would share the banquet of the kingdom. According to your promise, look with mercy on those who have walked with Christ in this life and now have passed through death. Lord, in your mercy. Amen. Almighty God, grant that your church may faithfully hold and make known the faith that has come to us through the apostles, that with them and all your saints we may inherit the glories of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Would you please stand? We are fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God, through Christ our Lord, who came and preached peace to those who were near and to those who were far off. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Our offertory hymn is number 503.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good that we should give you thanks, praise and glory, Almighty and everlasting God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For after his resurrection, he sent out his apostles and evangelists to preach the gospel to all nations and lead us in the way of truth. Himself the chief cornerstone, he founded his church upon the apostles, firmly to stand forever, as a sign of your holiness upon earth, and a living witness to all of the way that leads to heaven. And so with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we lift our voices and join in their unending hymn of praise. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering himself, made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise, and as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever.
We break this bread to share in what is Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Thank you.
Lord God, the source of truth and love, keep us faithful to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, united in prayer and the breaking of bread, and one in joy and simplicity of heart, in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God, who has prepared for you a city with eternal foundations, bring you with all the saints to the eternal and triumphant joy of that city. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Amen.